Welcome to the Christian Foundation course, everybody. We're up to study number 45. Let's get straight into it. John 7 and verse 37, the promise of the Holy Spirit. On the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out. Who stood and cried out? The Lord Jesus Christ himself, saying, If anyone thirsts, could that be you? Could you be a believer and still be thirsting? Let him come to me and drink. You know what? Maybe you're going to the wrong place. Maybe you're going to your denomination. Maybe you're going to your leaders. Maybe you're going to your medication. Maybe you're going to your drugs. Maybe you're going to your smokes. Maybe you're going to your friends. Jesus said, anyone that thirsts within his soul, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, maybe your belief in Jesus isn't correct. Maybe you need to re-examine that. As the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water. So you won't be dry, you'll be flowing. But this he spoke concerning what? The Holy Spirit, the Spirit whom those believing in him would receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given because Jesus was not yet glorified. So how important is the Holy Spirit today? You've got these clowns saying that the Holy Spirit's not relevant on the one hand. And then you've got these ministers that are trying to teach you that the Holy Spirit's so important to you it's not funny. It's wonderful, isn't it? When you're thirsting, you come to Jesus and drink, and he fills you with the Holy Spirit. Now, we're changing the thrust a little bit. We're keeping our focus on the Holy Spirit, but we're going into the struggles that you can have in the Christian life. In 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 9, Paul speaking to Timothy says, "Be diligent to come to me quickly, for Demas has forsaken me." Why did he abandon Paul? Because having loved this present world, he has departed for Thessalonica. So Demas loved the world, things of the world. He had other things that he was interested in that were more important to him at that time than continuing in the ministry with Paul. And down in verse 16 of 2 Timothy 4, Paul says, "At my defense, no one stood with me, but all forsook me." So Demas just wasn't the only one. It says all forsook Paul in this particular incident. May it not be charged against them. But being a merciful man, he understood that things are going to pull at people and they are going to forsake their Christianity at certain different times, for certain different reasons, under certain different pressures. It's very hard to continue in the thing in a good and proper way. Like, there's Jehovah's Witness elders that are continuing in the thing and other cult member elders that are just wrong. So in some ways it would pay them to forsake the ministry and get themselves right and then come back in a more fit form, an accurate form. I mean, it takes 1 minute to do a bit of research, and I'm going to do a video on how to research to know that these cults are wrong. 1 minute it takes. Now in Acts 13, Paul's on a missionary trip. In verse 13, "Now when Paul and his party set sail from Paphos, they came to Perga in Pamphylia, and John, departing from them, returned to Jerusalem." Now what or why John departed, we do not know, but we do know it caused some dissension. And we see this in Acts 15 and verse 36. "Then after some days, Paul said to Barnabas, 'Let us now go back and visit our brethren in every city where we have preached the word of the Lord and see how they are going.' Now Barnabas was determined to take with them John called Mark, but Paul insisted that they should not take with them the one who had departed from them in Pamphylia." That was John, wasn't it? "And had not gone with them to do the work." So Paul was worried that John might drop out again and it would just be a waste of time taking him. Like, comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I thank you for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the next talk. Yeah, Dr. Jason Morrison, theologist again. I just want to say thank you for watching the videos, and I hope you got plenty of self-rediscovery and freedom out of it. If you watched it on YouTube, please share or like, maybe even comment. If you watched it on Facebook, like, comment, share. But most of all, get out and live. This isn't a rehearsal. You've got a one old life. Don't let your loyalty and your faithfulness blind you to the life that you should be experiencing. Till the next video, thank you for watching, and bye for now.